My name is Mark, and this is the story of Two-Wheel Driver. During the summer of 1999, I fell in love with a girl named Randy. We met in Atlanta while working in the music industry. Randy was a cancer survivor, and after a five-year cancer-free party in 2001, we thought we would spend the rest of our lives together. Everything changed later that year when Randy began to have trouble breathing. The tumor had grown back right behind her heart. A few days before surgery to remove it, I proposed to Randy at her hospital bedside. She said yes. Early in the morning on Thanksgiving of 2003, after a long two-year battle, my world changed forever when Randy passed away. Just 29 years old, she was the love of my life. Dealing with grief is an individual journey. And after losing Randy, I needed to do something life-affirming. So I got my motorcycle license and became a rider, which was the best thing I could have ever done. Not long after my first cross-country trip, I realized that golf clubs could be strapped to my motorcycle just like my other gear. And before long, I was regularly heading out on two wheels to play golf. My passion for motorcycles and golf had combined to become the best therapy I could think of. The phrase two-wheel driver popped into my head during one of my motorcycle golf excursions, and it never left me. I knew there was something that could be done with it, and that was when the idea was born. So what exactly is two-wheel driver? It's my chance to help others fight back against cancer. My weapons of choice: motorcycles, golf, and music. The plan: travel across America on motorcycles, host charity golf tournaments by day, and benefit concerts at night. The goal: to raise as much money as we can for local cancer causes and have a great time doing it. Already this year, during our travels to Utah, Indiana, and Georgia, we've been able to spread our message and make two donations. We made our first donation to the Indiana University Cancer Center in September while attending the inaugural Red Bull MotoGP at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. In fact, it was the Speedway staff who suggested the IU Cancer Center.
I wish it was more, but it's $1,000.
That's wonderful. That is so wonderful. Congratulations, you guys.
While there, we met a lot of great people, including this guy, had a blast at the race, and handed out a ton of information about two-wheel driver. We even played a round of golf at the Brickyard Crossing Golf Course, which is located at the Speedway and has four holes located inside the track itself. In November, we made our second donation to the Georgia Center for Total Cancer Care, located in the North Georgia Mountains. We did this after we held the inaugural two-wheel driver golf and music events over 2 days in October here in our hometown of Atlanta. We had perfect weather, an immaculate golf course at Wolf Creek, a renowned music venue in Smith's Old Bar, and three great bands. Most importantly, we received an outpouring of support from a dedicated group of people.
We've already raised about a little over $6,000 from the golf tournament yesterday, so thanks everyone who participated in that.
Between both events, we raised over $8,000. It was awesome handing over a check to the Georgia Center that they're going to use to expand their patient parking lot. Ultimately, two-wheel driver is my chance to help those battling cancer by bringing together the three things that helped me deal with my grief: motorcycles, golf, and music. Together with my good friends and fellow riders, Bill, Brad, and Wes, and our sponsors, KTM, Bike Bandit, and 13th Green, we plan on raising as much money as we can for the ongoing battle against cancer. Two-wheel driver. Motorcycles plus golf plus music versus cancer. You with me?
So you're out there on the street, shedding your second skin. You can't help but to repeat running the rat race on the road to ruin. Secrets kept quiet. The catastrophe out of the bag. Every
score.